In section 4.3, we will discuss another terminology which we call the electric displacement. So this is section 4.3, the electric displacement. The electric displacement D. We have another subsection in this one, Gauss's Law in the presence of dielectrics. So this is 4.3.1, Gauss's Law in the presence of dielectrics. Now here, we know from our previous knowledge that when a material is placed, when a dielectric material is placed inside an electric field, then polarization occurs. And that polarization causes or is a result of the creation or the generation of charges, which are surface charges and bound charges, and they produce their own electric field. The surface charge, which is the sigma bound, is P dot N, and the volume bound charge, sigma rho B, rho B is minus divergence of polarization, divergence of P. So the field due to polarization is basically due to these bound charges, and there it's a result of an external applied field. So we have to write the Gauss's Law for this polarization term, because the field can be due to free charges as well, free charges like in a conductor we are having. In dielectric, it may be due to the ions there. When they move, so, or when the ions are there, then they have the electric field. So we write that whatever is the reason behind this one, the charge density rho that we use in Gauss's Law can be written as the bound charge and the free charge here. And then we can write, as we know the Gauss's Law in differential form, divergence of E is equal to rho over epsilon naught. So this I can write is epsilon naught times divergence of E is equal to rho. And further, I can write epsilon naught divergence of E is equal to rho bound and rho free. And from here, the rho bound I can write is minus divergence of P plus rho free, the free charges volume density. So this is epsilon naught this, so I can write this thing is divergence of, and epsilon naught E from here. And when this will come to this side, then it will become plus and divergence of this. So I have taken the divergence here. So this is plus P equals rho F. And this term, which is epsilon naught P, epsilon naught E plus P, I call this electric displacement. And I write the divergence of D is equal to rho F, and this I call the Gauss's Law for dielectrics, or the Gauss's Law for free charges only here. Divergence of D equal rho F And further, I can write it in the integral form, means I can convert it into the integral form very easily. And if I do multiply this thing with the area, this is or with the volume here, divergence of D, and I multiply it with D tau, and I do integrate here, I multiply this rho free with D tau, and I do integrate, then this thing I can write with the help of the divergence theorem. The divergence theorem is that if we are having the divergence of a vector quantity V in volume, then this is the same if I take a closed surface integral here, and then I write the flux of that quantity V dA. So based on this one, I can write that divergence, the V dot dA, this I will write is V dot dA. So it will be D dot D, D dot dA, and a closed surface integral equals, and what about this one? This is the free charge multiplied with the volume, so this will be the enclosed free charge here. So this is the differential form of Gauss's law for free charges or for dielectrics, and this is the integral form of the same. Now it's a conceptual thing here that we have written the electric displacement D equal to epsilon naught E plus P, and wherever there is no polarization in a medium, then means where there P is equal to zero, then this will imply the D is equal to epsilon naught E. And one thing we will have to clarify here, one thing we will have to clarify, that is when we were doing this thing, then we only considered the volume bound charge and not the surface bound charge. Means both can exist. In polarization, there is contribution from both, but we only focus on this one due to the reason that one thing is symmetry. When there will be a symmetry, we can apply the Gauss's law for the dielectrics very easily to calculate the free charge there, or to calculate the electric displacement. It is easy to do this thing. But when we talk of the dielectric material, then the dielectric material means considering between the sigma B and sigma, this is sigma B and rho B. Why we focused only on the volume charge, volume bound charge, than the surface bound charge? Because when we consider a dielectric, then the ordinary dielectric material, they are not having sharp edges, like means the dielectric material, ordinary material, there are no sharp edges to that one. So the calculation of the volume is easier compared to the surface, because we mathematically the things will be difficult to do for the surface. So it is safe to use the Gauss's law only for the contribution of volume charge, because on the sharp edges, when we have the sharp edges, then the divergence of E, the electric field will blow up. That's why we have to only use this thing. The other thing is that it is giving, Griffiths is giving a different section to that one, which is the a deceptive parallel, and then another section of the boundary conditions. So I will not write the boundary conditions or the deceptive parallel as a separate section, but I will try to explain this thing with this law here, that what is basically the difference between D and E. When I look here, means one thing, can we calculate D inside and outside of the dielectric? So the answer is yes, we can, because when we are inside a dielectric material, then we can calculate D, because we will have the polarization and then we are having the electric field as well. So inside the material, we can do calculate the electric displacement easily. It is means D is considered is the electric field counterpart inside the material. So somehow this is right, but there are differences which we will have to take into account. Like here we say that, can we calculate D outside the dielectric material? So the answer is again yes, we can calculate, because outside the material P will become zero and D will be equal to epsilon naught times E. Now again we revert the question, and the question is that, can we calculate the electric field inside a dielectric material? So the answer is no, we cannot, because we don't know the polarization term there inside the dielectric material. And can we calculate it outside? So of course yes, we do calculate outside the dielectric material this electric field, and that electric field is basically due to the creation or the generation of the surface in the volume bound charges. So we do this thing.